Let it rain. Open the floodgates of heaven. Let it rain. Let it rain. Open the floodgates of heaven. Sing out. Let it.
Let's thank the Lord for opportunity again to gather together at the feet of the Lord. Let's appreciate him for the teachings we have been receiving from the beginning of this year. Let's thank him specifically for yesterday, whereby we have been instructed to obey him completely, whereby we have been told that his way of operation is different from our own. Let's thank him. Father divine, I want to thank you, King of glory. I want to praise you. Only one of Israel, I adore you for your faithfulness and your mercy. Thank you for the opportunity to be a partaker of this forum. Accept my thanks in Jesus' name. Thank you for the word of life with which you have been building me up from the beginning of this year. Thank you. Thank you for the different messages that have been birthing transformation in my life. I appreciate you. I adore you. I magnify you. Be thou glorified in Jesus' name. Thank you specifically for the teachings of yesterday, whereby I am told that total obedience, complete obedience, is what will produce signs and wonders in my life. Father, I thank you. Lord, I praise you. Please accept my thanks and my praises in Jesus' name. Holy One of Israel, I'm here again to be taught by you. Please, Lord, send your word to me. In Jesus' name we pray. Let's ask God to speak to us today in the language where we all understand. My Father, my God, in the name of Jesus, I want to hear your voice to say, you know your sheep and your sheep knows you. They hear your voice and they follow you. I want to follow you, oh God. And that's what I'm saying today. Speak to me, Lord. Speak to me, Lord. Speak to me, Lord. Speak to me, Lord. Give me understanding of your word in the name of Jesus. In Jesus' name we pray. Lover of our souls, we want to thank you so much for your loving kindness. We appreciate you for the word of life through which our lives is experiencing transformation on a daily basis. We are so grateful. Please accept our thanks in Jesus' name. Father God, we are thanking you specifically for yesterday, whereby you told us that total obedience will make us to be recipient of your signs and your wonders. Lord, we thank you for all this word of life. Accept our thanks in Jesus' name. Thank you because whenever we pray, you always respond. And we've asked you for grace to obey you completely, which we trust you have released upon us. We've asked you to make us sensitive to the Holy Spirit. We believe you have done it for us. Jehovah, be thou glorified in Jesus' name. Another forum has come, O God, to hear your voice. Please, Lord, speak to us in the language we will all understand in Jesus' name, that at the end of the sharing of today, our lives will become better. Blessed be your holy name. In Jesus' name we pray. Amen. Welcome to the presence of Jehovah today, Wednesday, 22nd of March. It is my prayer that God will meet you at the point of your needs. It is my prayer that this day, the Lord will focus his attention on you. He will hear you when you call. He will send determined helpers across your path in the name of Jesus. The body bearers will bear your body in the name of Jesus. This day, God will remember you for good in Jesus' name. The topic today says, associated with change. It's a question. Are you associated with change? What does that mean? Well, as we share together, the Lord will teach us and we will know what we are being told by the Holy Spirit. A memory verse, as usual, is taken from 2 Corinthians 5:17. And I pray that all these words will be committing them to your hearts Because if you look at the open heaven, it is written there, memorized. All these memory verses are scriptures that Daddy is encouraging us to put into our hearts. 2 Corinthians 5:17 says, therefore, if any man be in Christ, he is a new creature. All things are passed away. Behold, all things are become new. What are the old things that must pass away? I believe you know them. Turn your Bibles with me to Colossians chapter 3. And I read verse 5. Mortify. Mortify means put to death. Therefore, your members which are upon the earth, fornication, uncleanness, inordinate affection, evil concupiscence, and covetousness, which is adultery. Verse 6. For which things sake the wrath of God cometh on the children of disobedience. Take note of verse 7. In the which ye also walked sometime when ye live in them. But now, that's verse 8. Ye also put off all this anger, wrath, malice, blasphemy, filthy communication out of your mouth. 9, the last verse. Lie not one to another, seeing that ye have put off the old man with his deeds. So what are the old things that must pass away? They are listed from verse 5 to verse 9. You can't say you are a child of God and you still tell lies and you feel comfortable with it. I just need to cover up. If I should say the truth now, they've inflicted some punishment on me. It's a sign you are not yet regenerated. If you are born again, all things will pass. Lie will no longer be found on your mouth. Anger will become a foreigner. Malice, there are some of us, when you cross their path, they vouch never to have anything to do with you again. When you greet them, they don't answer. They pretend to don't hear. They keep malice. They find it difficult to forgive people. Some are not married, yet they sleep with opposite sex. You know them. Those are the old things. The Bible says, these must not be in our lives. It must pass away. So each time we read the word of God like this, it's for you and I to assess ourselves. One of my favorite scriptures, 2 Corinthians 13:5, it says, examine yourself. You are not to examine me. Neither am I to examine you. Each one of us, we have to examine ourselves. When the Bible says all things must pass away, we have looked at the old things. Then it's for you and I to sit down and assess ourselves. Put yourself on the balances of the word of God. Are there some of these old things that you see found in my life? Then if they are there, what do I do? I need to pray through. They must pass away. There must be a clear-cut difference between a child of God and a child of the devil. Your life you are living now in Christ must be different from what it used to be. Therefore, if any man be in Christ, he is a new creature. All things are passed away. Behold, all things have become new. There must be newness in the way you think, newness in the way you dress, newness in the way you interact, newness in the people you keep company with. Our text is taken from Deuteronomy chapter 28, verse 11 to 13. Deuteronomy 28, 11 to 13. And the Lord shall make thee plenteous in goods, in the fruit of thy body, and in the fruit of thy cattle, and in the fruit of thy ground, in the land which the Lord swore unto thy fathers to give thee. The Lord shall open unto thee his good treasure, the heaven to give the rain unto thy land in his season, and to bless all the work of thy hand. And thou shalt lend unto many nations, and thou shalt not borrow. And the Lord shall make thee the head, and not the tail. And thou shalt be above only, and thou shalt not be beneath, if that thou hearken unto the commandments of the Lord thy God, which I command thee this day to observe and to do them. I know that as I was reading, so many of us out there will be saying, amen, 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 which is a good thing. But do you pay attention to the last verse? The last part of verse 13 says, there is a condition for all those pronouncements to come to pass in your life. There's a condition to be made. It's not just automatic. Because I'm a child of God, then I will have abundance. Because I'm a child of God, then I will be fruitful. Yes, the basics is for you to be a child of God. But you have to be an obedient child of God for the promises of God to come to pass in your life. The moment you are born again, you are entitled to all the blessings that God has. As long as you obey his word. As long as I allow the word of God to have his place in me, then all these things will come to pass. If you look at verse 11, where we started from, blessings were pronounced. But like I've said, all these blessings will come to pass if we choose to live a holy life. Proverbs 10:6a, the A part of verse 6. Turn your Bibles, please, with me to Proverbs chapter 10. Because some of us are wondering, I've been a child of God. I've been praying. I've been fasting. Yeah, nothing is happening. Nothing will happen until we align ourselves with the standard of God. Proverbs 10:6a says, blessings are upon the head of the just. Or in another way, blessings are upon the head of the righteous. If we choose to live a righteous life, if I choose to live a righteous life, all the pronouncements here, they're automatic. God has said, we'll be plenteous in goods. He will ensure that materially we are blessed. He will ensure that financially we have more than enough. That's why I said we'll be lending to nations. On the condition we choose to obey him. On the condition you and I will make up our mind to do his will no matter what. But if we will not choose to do his will, then his good counsel might not be fulfilled in our lives. God will help us in Jesus' name. If you look at verse 12, which I will want to draw your attention to, there's a particular statement there. God said to bless all the work of thy hand. Our God is not a magician. You need to learn to work. That some of us, we are lazy. And yet when the blessing of God, after all the word of God says, I be head, I will not be the tail. I be the first, I will not be the last. I be lending to nations. Don't just interpret the word of God out of context. Verse 12, I want to read it to you. The Lord shall open unto thee his good treasure, the heaven to give the rain unto thy land in his season, and to bless all the work of thy hand. And thou shalt lend unto many nations, and thou shalt not borrow. there is no work in your hand, then what will he bless? What will he bless? 1 Thessalonians 4:11. 1 Thessalonians chapter 4 and verse 11. It says, and that ye study to be quiet, and to do your own business, and to work with your own hands, as we commanded you. God wants us to work. He will only bless you when you have the work you are doing. 2 Thessalonians 3:12. Now them that are such we command and exhort by our Lord Jesus Christ, that with quietness they work and eat their own bread. So you can't say you are a child of God, you want the blessing of God, while you refuse to work with your hand. The same verse 12, there's another important thing I want to draw our attention to. God does not plan that his children will be borrowing. He doesn't want you to be a beggar. You are not supposed to borrow. That's why he said, and thou shalt not borrow. So those of us who have enjoyed living on credit, we think it's the best of life. It negates the word of God. Thou shalt not borrow. His plan for you is to have abundance. One of the reasons why we borrow is because we are biting more than we can chew. When we are still supposed to be managing some things, we want to live in affluence. We just started our life. We just started working 2 years ago. You want to have something that somebody who has started 20 years ago is already having. And so, we go into credit world. We now begin to buy things on credit. It's not a counsel of God. Thou shalt not borrow. Cut your coat according to your available cloth. And God will begin to enlarge you, expand you. He will take you from one level to the other. One level of glory to another. When you are supposed to be riding a tricycle, don't go and take loan and buy a Jeep. Why? Because everybody is riding a Jeep. Do you have the same financial status? It is not the counsel of God that his children should borrow. Romans chapter 13 and verse 8. Romans chapter 13 and verse 8. The Bible says, owe no man anything. Owe no man. You are not supposed to owe anybody. But to love one another, for he that loveth another hath fulfilled the law. So if you are owing, you are a debtor. And you are negating the plan of God for your life. You are not supposed to be owing. And as a matter of fact, when you enjoy this credit facility, this life of borrowing and borrowing, let me prove it again to you from the word of God that you'll be negating the word of God, because that's not the counsel of God. Proverbs chapter 13 and verse 22. Proverbs 13, 22. A good man leaveth an inheritance to his children's children, and the wealth of the sinner is laid up for the just. As a child of God, you are supposed to leave wealth for your children. But when you have enjoyed this issue of going on loan, taking loan, this and that, if debt comes, what do you leave behind for your children? Debts. Like the story we studied yesterday. You are not supposed to leave debt for your children. You are supposed to leave wealth. That's why, one, we should learn to work. Two, we should learn not to do more than our financial strength can carry us. We should not enjoy the life of credits. It's not the plan of God. It enslaves you. The borrower is a slave to the lender. It enslaves you. God will help us in Jesus' name. If there is any single word that symbolizes Jesus Christ, it's the word change. While some changes are for good, some others have negative consequences. Encountering Jesus Christ brings positive change to you. Everything about Jesus first changed. The moment he was born into this world, things began to change. Even the old calendar was changed to reflect the years before Christ was born, B.C., and the years after he was born, A.D. By his virgin birth, he introduced change to the rules of childbirth. This is why menopause can become menoplay. By the change he brought, we have seen a 56-year-old woman testifying before the people of God with her newborn baby. No wonder Jesus said, God can raise children out of stones. Matthew 3:9. Are you trusting God for the fruit of the womb? But menopause is telling you that your time is past. Tell it that because your Savior and Master, Jesus, stand for change, it cannot stand in your way. Shortly, in the name of Jesus, you shall celebrate with your own baby. I think someone out there will say amen. The question again is this true about your life? Daddy said everything Jesus stands for is change. Since you claim that Jesus has become your owner, is there any change in your life? Can your old friends see you and they are bewildered? What? Johnson? James? Margaret? What happened? And you ask them, like what? You changed! Oh, you say it's Jesus. They hear the way you now speak. They see the way you now dress. You that use sarcastic language before. Foul languages, dirty language. Now you speak graciously. They look at you, what happened? You that you smoke cigarettes, you lit one cigarette with another. As you are dropping a packet, you are taking another. Now things have changed. You that used to be a womanizer, now things have changed. You that used to be sickly, you are always in and out of hospital, now you are enjoying sound health. You that they know your story, that before you knew Christ, you used to be a public dog, now you have changed. You are now living a decent life. You say, what? What has happened? Change. Can people see change in your life? If any man be in Christ, is a new creature. All things have passed away. They have all become new. If you are connected to Jesus, you cannot but experience glorious changes in your life. Nothing that he created can stand in your way. If what he created cannot stop you, how then can the evil forces and evil mechanisms that were designed by the odds of hell stop you? They also answered to him. Indeed, the moment he walked on water, he not only defied the law of gravity, he also made it respond to his will. Matthew chapter 14, verse 23 to 27. We have that story there. Can we please open to Matthew chapter 14? Matthew chapter 14, verse 23 to 27. And when he had sent the multitude away, he went up into a mountain apart to pray. And when the evening was come, he was there alone. But the ship was now in the midst of the sea, tossed with waves, for the wind was contrary. And in the fourth watch of the night, Jesus went unto them walking on the sea. And when the disciples saw him walking on the sea, they were troubled, saying, it is a spirit. And they cried out for fear. Verse 27, the last verse. But straightway Jesus spake unto them, saying, be of good cheer, it is I, be not afraid. He walked on water. Love gravity. That when you throw things up, it must come down. Remember, it never worked when it was time for God to take away Elijah. Elijah was taken away, and law of gravity was not able to pull him down. God will help us in Jesus' name. So what are we saying? Everything he created, they obey him. Law of gravity could not pull him down when he was walking on water. He also made it to respond to his will. So we should not be afraid that this is what the Lord says. He can change them to be his will in our lives. By this act, the man who said, what goes up must come down, began to have problems with his postulates. If you encounter Jesus, you can go up and stay up. This is why Deuteronomy 28:13 says, and the Lord shall make thee the head and not the tail, and thou shalt be above only. He will take you up, you will stay up, you will never come down. And thou shalt not be beneath, if thou hearken unto the commandments of the Lord thy God, which I command thee this day to observe and to do them. Is the law of gravity affecting your business, your ministry, your academics, your family, or spiritual life? I command its download effect to cease dragging you down from now on. From today, you shall go up, and your ascent shall be unstoppable. You shall be there ahead. Amen. I say amen to that. I receive that for myself. Ask for a definite encounter with Jesus today. If you have not accepted Jesus as the Lord and personal Savior, it is the best place to start. Key point. If you have Jesus, you will be an agent of positive change everywhere you go. Do you reflect his change? Prayer point. You want to say, Father, help me to cause positive change wherever I go. My Father, my God, cause me to positive change wherever I go in the name of Jesus. Cause me, oh God, make me to cause positive change. Make me to cause positive change wherever I go in the name of Jesus. Make me an agent of change. Make me an agent of change. Make me an agent of change by the virtue of what you have done in my life. Oh, others will come to know you. Thank you, Father. In Jesus' name we pray. O thou that answereth prayers, unto you shall all flesh come, even as we have cried to you today, that you make us an agent of change. So let it be in Jesus' name. Make us to cause positive change wherever we go in life in Jesus' name. And every trace of old man that is still remaining in us, flush out today with your blood in Jesus' name. Thank you, blessed Redeemer. In Jesus' name we pray. Amen. Can we please sing in?
Never be discouraged. Take it to the Lord in prayer. Can we find a friend so faithful who will all our sorrows share? Jesus knows our every weakness. Take it to the Lord in prayer. Are we weak and heavy laden, cumbered with a load of care? Precious Savior, still our rest. To the Lord in prayer. You, thy friends despise, forsake me. Take it to the Lord in prayer. In his arms he'll take and shield thee. Thou wilt find a solace there in his arms. Let it rain. Open the floodgates of heaven. Let it rain. Let it rain. Open the floodgates of heaven. Sing out. Let it rain.